Should I keep the Twitter going or not? Keep it going?
President Trump has been lining up feather-ruffling tweets since his inauguration. But on Capitol Hill, the Democrats have been flocking to social media, too.
Join me by calling your congressperson.
Upping their aptitude for a new era of political communication.
The tools are more limited for, say, the minority party right now. The more attention they can draw to something, the more likely it is they are able to get some sort of victory out of it.
Adam Connor helped open Facebook's first Washington office. For years now, he's been helping members of Congress learn how to use social media.
Donald Trump has demonstrated that social media is a tool that can have power and authenticity and is something that they can no longer ignore.
Minority Leader Chuck Schumer is overhauling the Democratic Media Center and implementing a broad new strategy.
We are reaching the American people where they are. Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter. Hi, everybody.
It's just in time for controversial confirmation hearings that most constituents didn't watch live. What many did see were short, shareable snippets meant to sway their opinion.
Okay, is that a yes or a no?
I support accountability.
Do you not want to answer my question?
This clip of then-Education Secretary nominee Betsy DeVos received more than 25 million views on Senator Schumer's Facebook page. In response to EPA nominee Scott Pruitt, Senator Cory Booker posted his floor speech.
May I have the floor?
And Hawaii Senator Brian Schatz posted this series of hashtagged memes touting the EPA's importance.
She was warned.
Earlier this month, Republicans stopped Democratic Senator Elizabeth Warren from presenting an opposing view of then-Attorney General nominee Jeff Sessions from Coretta Scott King.
I am surprised that the words of Coretta Scott King are not suitable for debate in the United States Senate.
So she logged on to Facebook Live.
I just want to read the letter.
It used to just be the moment on the day of the hearing was when people paid attention to it. But now you have this after effect. It's the memes. It's the unflattering clips. And so it really is a full cycle that is what the nominees have to kind of weather.
After President Obama's inauguration in 2009, Republicans stepped up their social media game as well, beginning a years-long messaging competition with the White House.
The president made an outstanding choice.
Now both parties are seeing more followers. They're sharing talking points on more platforms than ever, but also adding to the plethora of false information.
Just this morning, Flynn tweeted, and this is a quote, scapegoat.
Congressman Elijah Cummings and House Democratic leader Nancy Pelosi.
It's not scapegoat, it's Stonewall. And that's exactly what the Republicans in Congress are doing.
Bested by a fake account for ousted National Security Advisor Michael Flynn on Tuesday.